Crossstitch the Globe. I'm Stephanie.
I'm Allison.
This is a channel about cross-stitch. Today is a tutorial. We have three kinds of videos on our channel. These beginner tutorials we call Flosstube University. They come out on Thursdays. And today we are going to talk about how to use Floss-A-Way bags for storage, for floss storage. We're in the middle of a floss storage series. We have already covered bobbins and floss drops. Mm-hmm. And next week we will cover thread keeps. So if you're looking for fun storage solutions, subscribe. On Mondays we come out with alternating topics. So every other Monday will be a big Flosstube episode, which is a very deep dive into our personal stitching. If you've never watched a Flosstube, buckle up. They're very fun. You get a lot of like personal drama. You learn a lot about psychology when you watch Flosstube. And we recommend a lot of Flosstubers we love. So you
family
won't just,
drama. No, I'm just kidding.
Yes. Well, we're sisters, so yes. We recommend a lot of Flosstubers we love. So you'll hear about like, you know, if you have never dipped your toe into the world of Flosstube, come in. The water is weird.
Very friendly.
The water is very friendly.
It's
and
really warm. And
there
kind.
Is an undertow. You will never come back. And then in the other Mondays in between, we do Flosstube extras, which might be something like a whip parade where we get out all of our whips. That's something a lot of channels do. Mm-hmm. Or it might be something that we're like weirdly interested in. Like we just did, Allison just talked to us about what it was like when she was a monogamous stitcher in the past before she's had 20 whips.
Or she had an existential crisis.
We had, you know, like we came out with a free summer pattern series. Yeah. Or we're going to eventually, I promise, for real record the most expensive cross-stitch magazine that will be coming up soon. So subscribe. If you're not subscribed, we'd love to have you. For today, let's talk about Floss-A-Way bags. So you're like, I don't love bobbins, but I also don't want to deal with floss drops. What is an inexpensive floss storage solution that will work for keeping the floss in my project, but also will work for when the project's over?
And this is where you started, right?
It's the second thing I did. Because the first thing I did was bobbins. Didn't love it. Didn't really understand floss drops or like want to invest in them because they are an investment unless you make your own. If you want like the level that you can store in their investment. And Floss-A-Way bags aren't too bad because you get 100 for like $8. Mm-hmm. They might be a little more expensive if you're seeing this in the future. Inflation. But when I started, when I was buying them, you could get 100 bags for $8. And I use Floss-A-Way bags two ways. Let's talk about in the project. So this set of Floss-A-Way bags lives in my, this is my Mirabilia Cinderella. So, and this one is Mirabilia's Elizabeth and the Lavender Sky. So what I would do before I switch to floss drops is I would buy all the floss for a bigger project, a project that needed like 30 or 40. I would buy the bags for them. And then I started doing this. This is not what you need to do, but it is that I would bobbinate the floss. But what I was finding was that I didn't like having the open bobbins in the bag on the ring because they get a little messy. Mm. Right? But I didn't think about like leaving it on the skein because that seemed like tyranny, like anarchy, not tyranny. So I would bobbinate them and put them in the bag. But then I would get lazy and just put the thing in with the bobbin. And then I realized actually having it just on the skein in the bag was totally fine. And so this project is kind of a mix of bobbinated floss that are in bags. And then this project, I would just went directly to just putting it in the bags itself. And this is fine. The nice thing about Floss-A-Way bags is that you write your number on it. You can also write the symbol on it. So I actually like that better. I have the symbol on all of these bags. And then that is great too for blends because you can put both in there and say that's a blend, or you can say this is only in this blend. And actually using them, it's great because they don't take up much space. They take up less space than floss drops and bobbins, especially if you don't have them bobbinated. If they're like, this is a whole Mirabilia, a big Mirabilia in this tiny space. If you're worried about space, Floss-A-Way bags are great for the project. And I just stick this in the project bag. They never get messed up.
And I bet they're, I mean,
they're very cheap.
Yeah.
And then like, I just pull the skein, I pull it off the skein. You pull from the number. We have a whole video on how to separate six-stranded floss, so if you don't know how to do that, go watch that video. But then it's also great because you don't have to your working threads and the extra stuff, you don't have to wind it back up. I just kind of like roll it around and stick it back in the bag. So it's not knotted.
Yeah.
But I don't have to like put it back on the bobbin or put it back on the skein. Right. So very simple. And then at the end of the project, you just throw I've finished projects that were in these, and you like some project, you know, because so I actually have gotten to the end of a Floss-A-Way bag project, and like not this one. And you just take the thread out, do whatever you're going to do with the thread for storage, and throw the Floss-A-Way bag away.
This is not a storage solution.
It is, but it's not my storage solution. But it is. So for me, I just throw the bag away.
Okay.
And I have about 200 of these bags left. So I will probably use them for something at some point. But if I had it bobbinated, I would take the bobbin out and put the bobbin back in the box. But I'm never going to do this again because this takes so much time. But this is like pretty easy. So it's easier than bobbinating. It's a lot easier than setting up floss drops. It is very chill. You
it's
have a place.
Neater than the
it's smaller and neater. It's not expensive. Like it is actually a really nice system in the bag, like in the project bag when you're working on the project. Now it is kind of annoying to like open the bag up and pull the floss. But there's no perfect system, and it is it's so easy to set up. That, yes, the floss drops are easy to use. Floss drops are my favorite because when you're stitching, you're flying on them. But to set up a project, this is the best because this is the second best to just dumping all your DMC in a bag because actually sitting there and bobbinating and setting up floss drops sucks.
Yeah.
So now, if you want to store, I do know people who store all of their floss in Floss-A-Way bags permanently. Mm-hmm. And what they do is they have those little like index card plastic things that so they find a box that is about this wide, right? This is the size of a lot of index cards. So they do that and they have like however many they need to fill all their bags. But then what they do is they get a grippy thing to put at the bottom because these will just slip, right? They have no stay. So they get that rubbery like shelf liner, but not the one that's just a wallpaper looking thing, but the one that actually gives it a little bit of grip.
It's like rubbery.
Yes. Yeah. And you put that in the bottom of the boxes so that they have a little more staying power. And you also put enough in so that they're mostly stood up. So the box should be kind of squished full. And then you have that rubber at the bottom, and that keeps them from just like.
Yeah, they're very slithery.
Yeah. Which is great in the project bag, but would be so annoying.
Yeah.
Off the project bag. So that's why they do that grip.
Yeah.
And I've watched it on multiple videos. I've never been interested in doing that just because I already had other systems in place, but I actually very much like using them on a project. I never get annoyed when I pull a project bag out that I forgot was on Floss-A-Way bags and it's in Floss-A-Way bags. I'm like, okay, great. What annoys me is when it's on a bobbin in a Floss-A-Way bag. But once you take some strands off and you have just the working strands in the Floss-A-Way bag, it's way better than having it back on the bobbin. Like a million times better. And then what I do is because these rings tend to have more stuff on them and like be, I just put a little thing. Yeah. But I have a bunch of these like quilt square things and they're cheap. They were cheap for me because of where I got them, but they're not, I don't know. Anyway. So, Floss-A-Way bags are cheap. You can get them on Amazon. You can get them on 123 Stitch. You can get them at your local needlework shop. They're inexpensive. They're disposable, so you don't feel like you have to invest in them to decide if you want to do them. They're very great for project storage. If you want to do them as your permanent storage, then you have to go and be a little bit more clever with getting the boxes set up. But even that's easy. Like, if someone told me, oh, you have to use Floss-A-Way bags, there are no other ways to organize floss, I'd be like, okay, I guess I can do that. That's fine. I like how the floss drops work and I like how they function, but this is fine. And I like this better than bobbins.
Okay. I've only tried the bobbins.
I've never had this as my like permanent setup, so I don't know how that would be.
Yeah.
You also, if you were like Laura from Stitching by the Shore has those beautiful boxes behind her, you could do these for the project and then take the skeins and put them back in a shelf system.
Yeah.
I'll link to Laura's, how she set those up got like listed to me as like you should check out this video. And I watched it and I was like, oh, I want those. But what I would have to do is have four colors in a box because I can't do eight boxes, but I could do two boxes. Not now, but I could eventually do two boxes and have four colors per box, and that would be fine. But you could do that. You could have like permanent, like little drawer storage and just put these in your literal project.
Yeah.
And that would not be expensive. You also, I've done this. So my, my permanent DMC storage that is for all of my extras. I don't think you've ever seen this. I made these where I have, but I didn't buy the Floss-A-Way bags. I bought Ziploc bags and
hole punched them. Oh, I helped you put them together. Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Okay. I thought I did it at Mom and Dad's, but.
Well, I was over there.
Oh, okay. So I made essentially my own Floss-A-Way bags, which you could do too. But what I found was it actually sucks to sit there and hole punch Ziploc bags. So I would never do that again to myself. But I put a little, and I put a little label on it so I could write. And I did not save very much money because it was like, yes, I saved some money, but I didn't save enough money for the time. I should never have done that. But it's done, so it's over. But so I don't have my permanent stuff is in bobbin boxes, but my extra spillover, like my five whites that aren't my one white in the box, are in rings with plastic bags on them like this and two tubs that are like this size. So I have two tubs of excess DMC that,
yeah,
but it's like, unfortunately it's like a lot of the same colors.
Yeah. And check, aren't they older? Some of them are
a lot older. Of them are older. Yeah. Which is a whole other situation. But, so I do actually have permanent storage in something like this. I would like to move that to a drawer, but I wouldn't mind kitting up a project like this. And since I have extras, I probably will at some point be like, oh, that project has 100 colors. Let me do this one in Floss-A-Way bags and just kind of be like,
like, today I'm feeling excited.
Yeah. Like what, after I have my master storage system set up on like on thread bobbins, if I ever had a project where I need to go out and buy 100 skeins for that project, cause it was going to be like its own thing,
yeah,
then I might be like, it's time to pull out the Floss-A-Way bags. And I don't hate them. I mean, yeah, it's like yeah, they actually bring me a lot of joy.
That's good.
But they're just.
Well, you make it look easy.
They are easy.
Yeah.
It's like Floss Drops won in my heart over, but these are like the ex-boyfriend you wouldn't. Like if your boyfriend broke up with you and your ex-boyfriend gave you a call, you'd be like, we can go on a coffee date. I don't want to marry you. We can go on a coffee date. You know what I mean? All right, so if you made it to this point in the video, we would love if you subscribed. The next one, then we're going to do thread keeps, which are like the big pieces of wood or plastic that hold lots of floss on the same one. And I have some different.
That you'll see in like kits, usually.
Yeah. And I have some like plastic ones that I have. I have wooden ones. I have cardboard ones. So we'll go over how to do a project on those and also how to do a full collection on those, because one of our idols does have her whole master set on those. And so that'll be next week. And then if you are not subscribed and you've never seen a Flosstube, subscribe. And then when a Flosstube episode pops up, you got it. You gotta join us.
Jump in. It's crazy.
If you made it to this point in the video, leave any kind of bag, purse, any like human with a little man with a bag, a bag full of money, any kind of bag for these like beautiful little Floss-A-Way bag emojis. That'll be our secret language that you made it to this point. And guys, thank you so much.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.